Subtract 63 minus 29. Show your work.
Welcome back. Today's quest might look a lot like our last one, but one thing has changed. Can you spot the difference? Instead of adding two-digit numbers, we will be subtracting them or taking them away. We know how to do that, so let's get started. We should be able to solve this math quest no problem. First, we'll line up our numbers vertically by place value. Then, we'll start in our ones place and subtract 3 minus 9. Oh, wait a second. 3 isn't big enough to take away 9. It looks like we've discovered a new type of subtraction problem. The subtraction problems we've solved before have always had a bigger number on the top, so we could simply subtract each place value. Like in this problem, 8 minus 6 equals 2. 3 minus 2 equals 1. So our answer is 12. It seems like our quest will need an extra step. Let's look at a similar problem to see if we can figure this out. Grab your pencil and try this one with me in your guided notes. We have 42 minus 25 written vertically, and this time I added base 10 blocks to help us see what's happening. You might be wondering, why didn't you show both numbers in blocks like we did with addition? Well, in subtraction, we start with the bigger number and take away the smaller one, so we only need to build the bigger number with our blocks. In this problem, that's 42. Then we can start in the ones place. We have two ones, but we need to take away 5. Just like in our math quest, we don't have enough to take away our second number. Let's think back to our last quest. Remember regrouping? When we were adding, we had too many ones. We would exchange 10 of them for a 10 block. This is the opposite, though. We don't have enough. Wait. That's it. Addition and subtraction are inverse operations, or opposites. We need to do the opposite of what we did for addition. So if we put blocks together in addition, we'll need to break them apart in subtraction. Let's give this a try. If we need more ones, we can break apart one 10 block into 10 ones. We had 2, and we added 10 more. Now we have 12. We can cross out the 2 in our ones place and write a 12 above to reflect our new number. Since we took away 110, we also need to update our tens place. We can cross out the 4 and write 3. Make sure you record this in your notes. Got it? Great! Now we are ready to subtract. 12 minus 5 equals 7. I'll write that under the ones. And 3 minus 2 equals 1. I'll write that under the tens. Our answer is 17. We have another clue. Let's take a look. It looks like another rhyme, and it has blanks. Let's read it together and see if we can fill in the missing parts. The first part says, "More on top, no need to stop." That reminds me of this problem. Look, the top number is 8 and the bottom is 6. Since 8 is more than 6, we can subtract without regrouping. The next line says, "More on the floor, go next blank, and get 10 blank." What rhymes with floor and came up in our last clue? That's right. Go next door. And what do we do when we go next door? Yes, 10 more. That means we're regrouping. We're borrowing a 10 and bringing it to the ones place to help us subtract like we just did. The last one says, numbers the same, zero is the game. This must mean that when the top and bottom numbers are the same, like 5 minus 5, the answer is 0. This will help us with 3 different types of subtraction problems. Let's keep this in mind as we solve another. First, we'll look at the ones place. 3 minus 8. Is there more on top or more on the floor? There's more on the floor. 8 is bigger than 3, so what do we do? Let's check our rhyme. More on the floor, go next door, and get 10 more. We need to regroup. We go next door to the tens place, take 1 10, break it apart, and add the 10 ones to the ones place. Now, instead of 3 ones, we have 13. Let's show our work. Last time, we crossed out the number and wrote the new one on top. But here's another shortcut you can try. Just write a little 1 next to the 3 in the ones place to show it became 13. Easy, right? And don't forget, we took 1 10, so we need to cross out the 5 in the tens place. What do we write instead? Yes, 4. Now we are ready to subtract both places. Can you subtract the ones? Yes, 13 minus 8 equals 5. Let's move to the tens. 4 minus 2 equals 2. So 53 minus 28 equals 25. Great work. Okay, I think we're ready to return to today's quest. Let's challenge ourselves to do this one without base 10 blocks. Think about our rhyme as you begin in the ones column. What's our first step? Yes, there's more on the floor, so we need to go next door and get 10 more from our tens place. We can cross out our 6, and what do we write instead? Right, 5. Then we can add that 10 to our ones place to help us subtract. We can use our shortcut and add a 1 here to make 13 ones. Now we're ready to subtract. What do you get when you subtract the ones place? Yes, 13 minus 9 equals 4. How about the tens place? 5 minus 2 equals 3. So our answer is 34. And we showed our work, like the quest asked, by writing our regrouping steps above the problem like this. Good work! Write our final answer on your math quest while I input our answer. We did it! Now we know how to regroup in both addition and subtraction. Since they're opposite operations, regrouping works in opposite ways too. In addition, we group smaller place values to the next highest place value. In subtraction, we break apart a larger place value to get more of a smaller one. Remember, every problem has a solution, and we've got the skills to solve it. See you next time! Hey, hey.